Well, welcome back to the workshop, and the first full build of 2024, one of many, is Revell's new Aston Martin DB5. It's in 1/24th scale. It's from 007 James Bond, the movie Goldfinger of the James Bond series. It is the Aston Martin DB5, 122 parts. If you're looking to get this on order, that will be your stock number, 14554. I will link in the description if I have any pre-order information available at that time. This is in a Revell Germany-style boxing. It opens up on the sides instead of the conventional model top opening. You can see on the back here, full-color pictures give you an idea of the paint. The model on this box art has been painted, but we'll see, since this is from the Easy Click system, which is a new name for a snap tight. Since a lot of the older style snap tights can kind of have a negative connotation to them, people might think they're lower quality or less detailed. They kind of renamed the system. As you can see, compared to your average snap tight kit from the old days in 1/24th scale with the monogram name, where it would have like 45 parts in it, this one's going to be much more detailed. It's a much more modern engineering. Things should fit much better. There'll be way more detail on it. So the only thing about it that's really snap tight is that it's engineered so well, we won't need any glue if we don't want to use it to hold things together. Let's start taking a look at the parts inside the box when you get yours. First up, molded in black, we've got some interior parts like shifter. We've got the James Bond controls. See how that center console has the lid flipped open? That'd normally be the console top. It's got it flipped open, got your little gauge package in there. So we're gonna have some neat James Bond specific details about this car. It's not just an Aston Martin DB5. It's going to actually be a 007 car. We got that sweet right-hand drive on there with all the open gauge clusters, which leads me to believe we're gonna have gauge decals. The nice dashboard, all the little flip switches and control panels. We've got our steering wheel and linkage in here, molded in black on that tree. Also molded in black are our inner fenders for the front of the car with our boot underneath there. We've got some minor detail on there. We've got shock absorbers, shifter, more struts on there. We've got our differential. We've got our three pedals on there, differential cover. Looks like we have our brakes, our disc brakes, and steering. So maybe this has posable steering on it, being an easy click model. On this tree here, we've got our entire chassis, upper suspension arms, frame, spare tire mount in the trunk. It's even got brake lines molded in. So again, these are not the snap tights from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. These are very modern. We've got our rear suspension and drive line with a partial drive shaft on there. Because the drive shaft disappears into the chassis, you can see a little bit of it through there. Got our steering link, lower suspension, wheel backs, and pay attention, they are numbered individually. So there must be a reason for that based on how they sit. We can see the interior here, 2023 molding. So it was designed recently, and then obviously it's 24 when the kit's released. We've got our engine oil pan and transmission. Exhaust system, love that dual exhaust system on there. Molded in a nice silver. Separate exhaust pipes, yes, separate exhaust pipes. Bottom of our engine here, where this should snap into, I'm guessing. Nicely molded in a silver tone. We've got our interior, also molded in silver, those gorgeous bucket seats. Many are young lady, shut in these sheets. They shut in the seats? E-brake right there, so you can see the small details. Nice interior pieces. Got our door panels, going to have separate door rests. Seat backs, molded in. You can see the bottom. We've got all of our locator pins. We've got locators for the seats, for the center console. All nice modern engineering, like to see that. We've got part of our bodywork here. And I'm assuming wheel rings if you want the wheels to spin. Usually I glue those in place. I'm not a big fan of that stuff. We've got the beautiful DB5 body. This is molded in metallic silver, which on the show, you know, if stuff is molded in a nice color, I like to try to leave it. We've got our nice hood scoop on there. Grill inserts, we can see where the headlights are going to go in and key in directionally. See that little tab on each side? Got our turn signals, our front body molding, the grill's all going to go in. We can see where our mirrors are going to fit, windshield wipers. We're even going to have inserts for the vents on the side. Door handles will be pressed in, not molded in. We've got the ejection seat, would have to be on the passenger side. Everything is nicely done, crisp molding, not seeing any flash worth worrying about. The door panels are definitely deep. We'll just accentuate that with either a Gundam or fine line marker. You can see where our glass is going to go in along the trim. Same with our windshield. We can see the tabs that we're going to be putting our trim in with our glass, and then we can see that removable top for the ejection sheet, and then the ejection cover and part of our trunk, not our trunk, I wonder what part that is. The trunk's already molded in. Well, we'll find out when we start building, but this is our ejection seat cover, and it is molded in color. A lot of you are going to want to paint because we can see strong mold lines. Now I'm going to leave it alone so we can just gloss it up, but you can see where the plastic runs into the injection, where it's squirted in a liquid form. A lot of people don't like that. They'll be very upset about that. So just paint the body a nice silver metallic. I'm going to switch to the other side of the desk. We're going to get out the decal sheets, or the decals. Now these are the water slide decals that work just like normal water slides. We've got our dashboard surround. We've got all of our little emblems, reflectors. We got our little gauge here. We got our dash gauges, our little radar screen. We've got all of our different license plates on there. And then we've got even what this is. Can you see with the light reflecting? You see the clear carrier? They actually have it so that the glass can be has bullet holes in it. That's pretty cool, isn't it? So that's our water slide decal sheet on there. Then we have a vinyl decal sheet. Got the same bullet windshield. Got most of the same details, but not all of them. You can see like the dashboard surround is on the water slide, not on these decals. You can mix and match. Sometimes the dash decals are nicer to lay in vinyl because they're so shiny and they look like they have a glass surface. Same with our scope there. So you can mix and match, or for the youngsters, you can just use the decals and not have to worry about water slides. We've got a nice looking clear parts tree. A lot of stuff on here for an easy click kit. We've got our headlights. We've got our back glass, our side glass. We've got our nice installed headlights. We've got our marker lights and turn signals. We've got our windshield here. Well done, crystal clear. You can see my big fingers through there. Then we've got one and two chrome trees. Don't worry, we're not missing a wheel. It is loose in the bag. Be careful when you have yours. They are a nice cross lace pattern, a black wash, my Tamiya black wash that I use a lot of. That will go in there beautifully and make those look like good wire wheels. Bumpers, grill, we'll do a black wash inside the grill as well. Got our windshield wipers, those are super, super thin, so be very careful with those. And smaller chrome pieces, headlight surrounds, rear view mirror, bumperettes on there. All the details you see on the box are on the chrome trees. And then we've got our spinners. We've got our extended spinners for the James Bond parts. We've got our front bumper. And finally, wrapping up the parts in the kit, no name, solid rubber tires, excellent tread pattern on them, even extends to the side. That has a nice tread pattern. These are definitely a rubberish. They usually don't sand as well as vinyl to look rough. So sometimes you can give them a matte clear coat to make them, when you sand them, they don't look much different with these style rubber tires. And of course, we got the Revell Germany style full color manual. These are some of the nicest manuals in the business. open it up, gives you builder's tips, gives you your parts trees and all your proper parts call out if that's extremely important to you, and then full color building instructions, telling you where to put each part, how to paint everything, use your paint guide and all that. We just go through, tells you how to color those clear parts for your signals, your brake lamps. Excellent kit. So I'm going to start putting mine together and I'll be right back.
Thank you.
Well, I've had easier kits to build, but not much, especially the modern ones. A lot of times they have a bazillion pieces. This kit has a lot of nice detail that you don't even see in some glue kits, and yet is pretty easy to put together. The only one sticking point on the entire thing was on the front steering. You saw that I had to snip off some flash, and I had to open the hole so that the lower suspension arm could go all the way in. It was kind of filled in, and it kind of has some flash. But now we've got steerable front wheels on that axle. It's got full suspension, steering. We can go in and accent paint anything we desire. On the rear axle, I mean, it had both springs. It's got the trailing arms. It's got the differential, the cover, and even the differential brace on the back there. So for a press fit kit, it's just as detailed, minus the engine. The engine is here. I put the cover plate around the outside. It just press fits in. I'm going to repaint the exhaust and the engine to give it a more metallic sheen with metallic paints. So I'm leaving them all on the tree. We'll get the exhaust done up. We'll get the dual exhaust and the bottom of the engine all painted to look nice. And then it will look great under the car when we flip it over. The bumper, I was surprised. Those little bumperettes can be such a pain on older kits. On this one, they just slide through. And there's these little stoppers here, so that they can push out and stop. So you can pull them out for bond and then push them back in and make them stop each time. So that's pretty cool on there. And they designed that beautifully. Then we'll have our flip around plate. When we stick it into these grooves in the front of the car during the final assembly, we can go and put all of our decals on it for the license plates and rotate those around like he did in the movies. The rear bumper should go together the same. And it'll have the little pushers on the bumperettes with the little inserts, these little chrome rings that just press on, and none of that stuff broke or snapped when I was doing it. I don't want my car to roll off my shelves or, you know, anywhere I have them sitting when they're on the turntable and stuff. So I did glue those in. You can leave yours unglued. They fit in and they work fine if you want them to rotate. Did the steering column. And what I'm going to do is, obviously, I'm not going to be painting the body at all, nor the trim piece, nor the roof. And I finally found out what this piece is. This is the bulletproof window in the back. So this will slide up and stop the bullets. And that's what it was. It wasn't for the windshield on that decal sheet. I know you guys were just screaming away that new. This is actually a clear insert. And when you put this bulletproof wall in the way, on the back of the car, it will look like it's been hit by bullets, like they were shooting at him. So that's pretty cool, and that's what that part is. So now we know what that is, and that's fun to know that stuff. You know, if you don't know it right away, you learn it while you're building. I enjoy that. I don't need to know every single thing about a model kit when I take it out of the box or even when I see it on the shelf. If you see this on the shelf and you're like, I just want to build a DB5, you can do that. You can just build the Aston Martin. Or you can do all the cool little Goldfinger parts on it and stuff like that, that Moneypenny set it up with. So you can do it either way, and you don't have to know anything about an Aston Martin. You don't have to know anything about James Bond. Just build a model and have fun and let the experts scream into their phones or wherever they're watching this video, and I'm totally cool with that. The body looks great as it is. Like I said, the only part about the body that some people aren't going to like is that you've got this injection mark here where the silver-colored plastic flowed in. You know, when that's on top, you're going to see that unless you choose to repaint the body. You could do so. You could spray it a nice silver paint, and it would look beautiful. Underneath, since I'm not painting the body, I already snapped in the inner fenders. We've got an inner area underneath the boot. So technically you could open this up, find an engine, you know, say that they put a LS engine in it back in the, you know, in the 60s. I mean, it could happen. They time traveled or whatever. You could stick anything you want. You could find, you know, an engine or make one or whatever. So you do have these nice inner fender liners. And then one of the coolest parts of the kit is the rotating license plate in the back. That is just so cool. And we should have one in the front, of course, when we get done. But we've got that rotating plate, and it works wonderfully. I do have to use a tool, though, because my fingers are just too big to fit in there. But you can then rotate that around for all the different license plates to your heart content. I wanted to show how that assembles. That just press fits into place, and you can easily attach your decals and spin it, or you could attach your decals first and do whatever you want. Well, we've got that in there now, and then I just did a small drop of glue on either side to make sure that later when I'm pressing on this to move it, it doesn't take much pressure, but knowing me, I'd push it right through and it would fall in and then I'd lose my mind. So I glued that in, even though you probably don't have to, it'll probably hold. On the interior, it's just the seat backs and the door panels. And then if you want to build the DB5, they have a flat panel here that will go over it. I'm leaving mine open so we can see the little phone in there. Lots of details for James Bond. And then what I have to do with this interior is they've got the dark gray. I've seen pictures where it's black, it's dark gray. It depends on who's taking the picture and what angle. So I'm going to go with the kit colors. We will gloss up the seats and the back seat, and then we will paint the floors black by hand. Leave the center hump that dark gray. Put our black console on there. It'll look nice when we're done. We'll leave this gray back here for the fabric and all that. And that's how I'm going to do it. So I'm going to get just the minimal parts. We're going to do the exhaust. I'm going to paint the dash, and I'm going to paint the chassis. And I think that's about it. I'll paint the wheel back so that the color is the same on there. And then everything else is going to be done by hand. So join me over in the paint area. I'll be over there for just a few seconds. We'll be right back. What's going on, model peeps? You've been watching me work on the Aston Martin DB5 James Bond version. You can build a stock-ish DB5 with this kit. It does include the parts to cover up the phone inside. It does include the standard console, the standard shifter. It does include the standard center and dashboard and everything, so you can work on that. You would take this piece here, you would slide it all the way down and never lift it up to cover that gap, and you would permanently place the roof panel in there. Now, if you were going to paint the body and wanted to do a stock DB5, you could insert this panel and insert this panel and use some body filler and then paint over it and do all that stuff. I, of course, am doing the Bond version, so I want all that exposed. When I'm done, I want it to look like he's got everything deployed, because that's the point of this model for me. So we've got all that stuff worked up. The interior comes out really, really sharp. I did a little bit of a darker carpet, but not black. And then we've got our interior, the bucket seats. That dashboard looks phenomenal. The little grab handle there and the accentuating. I did use the vinyl stickers on the entire model so far, and I just wanted to see how those would come out, and they came out great. As you saw, I used that Mod Podge to seal over the top of those on the interior, so that, you know, in 6 months or so, the vinyl decals don't peel and fall off. That gives them a nice gloss coat, seals them in tight like a seal of paint, yet doesn't get harsh like paints could with something like that. Got our center console. I even did the little red button on the shifter there, flipped open. We got the phone access down there on that door. You can see it in there, and it's really cool. Everything about the part of that Aston Martin. I've got the engine in place and a basic exhaust, and then did some black wash and some dry brushing. I did not go in and detail anything, because honestly, once my model's all together, I'm done with it, and that's how it's going to sit. The black wash and those spoke wheels looks wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I didn't bother painting the brake rotors, because again, unless you're going to pull a wheel off, you're never going to see those. So I didn't detail any of that stuff, just because I'm not going to see it. A lot of you want to go ahead and detail that stuff, and I think that's awesome. But if you don't want to, it's going to look just fine. Got the front bumper done, ready to go on. You can see the little bumper push out. Some fit super tight. This one fits quite loose, but it's on there permanently. It's not going to go anywhere with those little stoppers there, you can see. This one you just have to pull out by hand. Once we get the bumper in place, you can gently pull that out. The front license plate will spin. We can turn that any which way we want. We can make it look like that, and that will push into the front end. On the body itself, I've got the headlights in place. The right one did not fit very tight, so I used a little bit of that clear Mod Podge to hold it in there. Nice, got the grill pushed in. Love that it's got the hood scoop molded open. We're ready for our trim on the side vents there, and I did just darken them with a little bit of a black wash so they stand out. We saw me do the door panels. We got our rear bumper. We got the rear license plate. We got our little bumper extensions here. They will slide out. These are much tighter than the front end, so I'll wait till the end. I've got the little tail lights that pop out that I think form little machine guns, and the marker lights. Now, we did notice something on the body. I know some of you are screaming at the camera already. When the body is upside down and you're working on the tail lights on the directions, the body is upside down here, you can see. The fenders are facing up. They tell you to put the red ones or the little red machine gun pop-outs right there. So when you turn the body over, it would be at the top. Okay? Turn the page. Still shows the same. Red light, no matter which way you go, at the top of the body. Now, I'm not an expert on the Aston Martin, and there's no detail of the back of the car on the box. When you go to put all the decals on the outside, it has the red on the bottom. I don't know which one is which. Doesn't matter. The way I built it is the way it's staying, because those are pressed in tight and I don't want to break them off now. So they're going to be on the top on this one. By the time I followed the manual and had that done and noticed the difference, it was too late because the lights didn't fit in very tight. So I put in a little drop of super glue on the back of them once they were pressed in. It's too late to go and change all that. So you should look it up online, see which way is the proper way. Once I saw it was different in two sections of the manual, I went and looked it up online. I'm not going to get into which one it was, but we'll just it's just staying the way it is. We got some small parts to put on that beautiful body when we're all done. We've got our door handles, our spinners, our windshield wipers, and then we've got the bond spinners to attach to the wheels. We put our inner spinner, which I put some black wash inside to make it look like this had been attached to it when it came apart. And we will attach those and slide those extra ones with the long pins. We'll put those in place. My bond car will look like all the stuff's been deployed when it is displayed, so everyone knows it's the bond ride. I'm going to wrap that up. When I get done, I will place the roof panel in and everything and give it a coat or two of floor polish or quick shine, get it to be glossy, and then we will have our final. Wrapping up the awesome Revell Aston Martin DB5 from Goldfinger, the James Bond ride. And yes, you can build a stock-ish DB5 from this kit. I mean stock-ish because of the roof panel being out and this rear panel. You'll still see the lines unless you want to use some body filler. But if you want to build a sweet 007 ride, an iconic ride, Sean Connery in Goldfinger, I expect you to die, Mr. Bond. Yes, one of the most famous 007 movies out there. This kit builds up beautifully, very easy to build. One thing only at the end, fitting the chassis into the body, it is extremely tight in the back end. So tight that I broke the rear axle using my fingers trying to pry it in. So just be careful, and I recommend putting the tires on after you get the body over the chassis. It'll be a tight fit, but the tires will go on. The wheels will go on after you do that. It sits properly. It all snaps together. It's got numerous features you could change out. It's got the spinning license plates. It's got the extending center caps. It's got the expanding bumpers for pushing. It's got the removable roof. Now, if you want to continue to take this roof in or out, I need to leave it a little loose so I can get some pictures in there. But if you don't want to press this in permanently, it's going to be very hard to get out once you attach it in place, especially with a gloss coat, and super especially if you put any paint on the model at all on the body. That roof will be difficult. You're going to have to use something very thin like your razor knife to pry it out and get it out every time you want to show it off. So I've left mine just sitting a little proud in the back. I'm going to leave all the James Bond stuff on mine the way it is because that's the way I wanted to build it. I didn't want to build it as a stock looking DB5. I want everyone that sees it to see, excuse me, that it is the James Bond 007 car. The headlights and headlight covers went on beautifully. On the left headlight, I had to use a little Mod Podge to hold it in place. But the covers themselves on the outside, those went on without a fight. This will rise up and down. The interior looks gorgeous. The trim, the mirrors, the door handles all push in without any sort of issue. I didn't have to worry about breaking this side trim, which I thought for sure I might do. The little rear license plate light, didn't have issues with that. I used the water slide decals once I got it all assembled on the exterior. The dash gauges all look great with the vinyl decals. I thought the vinyls might sit a little proud on the outside. So I used the Aston Martin on the front, the DB5 on the fender, the Great Britain decal, the DB5, the Aston Martin logo on the license plate light, and those went down beautifully, stuck in place, didn't take long to come off the backing paper, didn't rip, tear, crinkle, and then once those had dried, I brushed on a coat of future floor polish, and you can really see it shine. So this kit could be detailed in numerous ways. You saw me work with paint on the interior. On the exterior, I just highlighted the body panel lines with that Gundam marker and had no problems. I love the kit. Those wire wheels look awesome with a black wash in them. All the little details. It's really, if you didn't have this box to see it was easy click, most of you would be fooled. I mean, come on. You could also push this all the way down if you want, snap the roof in, put the spinners back on from the stock spinners. These are just friction fit all the way around, and you could change it in and out as much as you wanted. Push in the little bumperettes, all that kind of fun stuff. push your license plate around, but I'm gonna leave it displayed as it is. That's why I enjoyed it. First build of 2024, I loved it. It was very nice and it was very relaxing. Nothing frustrating except for getting that body in, and just be a little careful and leave the wheel and tire package off until it's assembled. Great work, Revell. Thanks for sending it. I will link in the description either the pre-order or the order link when it's ready for you folks. And we will see all of you at the next review.